A wonderful time with Pastor Bright Osagede from Shoreway International Christian Ministry. Pastor Bright, what is the reason why so many young people in our society today do not honor God?
Yes, that's, to be honest with you, sometimes when I think about it, it really makes me sad. Well, time will fail me to go into all the reasons why a lot of young people today do not actually honor God, but I'm just going to talk about two of them. One of them is because some of these people have actually just shut God out of their life. And that may be because of what they have heard about God or the experiences that other people have had, you know, with God. But my question is, how can you just throw away something that you've not tested? How can you judge something that you've not tested and you've not experienced it by yourself, and you say, oh, it doesn't work, it's not good, it's this, based on what you've heard from other people? Bible says, come, test and see that the Lord is good. So that's one reason. Another reason is that a lot of people, they have the consciousness of God in their life, especially young people. They have that consciousness of God in their life, but they believe that when I commit my life to God, I will not be able to have fun anymore. I can't go to the nightclub, I can't do this, I can't do that. You know, the Christian life, they believe, is a life full of do's and don'ts. You know, it's full of all kinds of restrictions. But like I said before, Bible says, come, taste and see that the Lord is good. I will not kid you, the Christian life is a life of discipline. But I tell you, it's good discipline. It's the kind of discipline that will shape you up, prepare you to be able to face life, so that you can make the right choices. And when you make the right choices in your life, you find that you enjoy life even better than so many other people.
There are some young people right now, Pastor Brad, that are struggling with some addictions in their lives. You know, today we live in a terrible world of, you know, sex addiction, drug addiction, and pornography, internet, and all. So what would you say to those to people who are listening right now to us? How can they have this release in their lives?
Yes, if you're listening to us right now, this moment, and you're going through some of these issues that Pastor William has just said, it's a very simple issue. All you need to know is that there's really no satisfaction in those things. At the end of the day, after the drugs, after the pornography, after the sex and everything else, at the end of it all, you find that you are actually empty. You find that you're worse than you were before you actually started. There's regret, there's all kinds of things, there's desperation, there's despair in your heart. The solution is to turn your life over to Jesus. He satisfies.
Amen. So maybe there's a young person now listening to you and say, you know, Pastor Brian, what you're saying is all good, but how can I turn my life to Jesus? What would you say to them, Pastor Brian?
Oh, turning your life over to Jesus is a very simple thing, because the Bible says if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord,
Amen.
He will accept you as his own.
That's simple.
That's it. It's that simple.
Wow.
That's it. You just need to make that simple decision and turn your life over to him and let him be the master of your life. You know, we say Jesus is our Lord and our Savior.
Amazing.
If you make him the Lord of your life, you find that all these addictions, all these depression and anger and, you know, everything boiling up within you, you hand it over to Jesus and he'll make you a new man.
Amen. So there is really freedom in Jesus.
Oh, absolutely. Wow, absolutely. Amazing. I've experienced it myself. I've seen hundreds of people who have experienced this same salvation.
Amen. It's good to hear that, Pastor. But we're going to come back, because there's a lot of people today who are lost hope and they feel there's no way for them. They are in a trap of sex addiction, of drug addiction, of pornography. Some people really feel they are lost and there's no other way for them. So it's good to hear that there is a hope for people who are struggling in that area. Thank you so much.